Good morning, students. Yes, very good. So we have completed our two lectures and today is our third lecture. Yes, students. Yes. In this third lecture, we are going to start with our very new topic. That is electroscopes. What is that? That is electroscopes. Students, electroscope is a device that is used to identify the charges as well as to check whether a body is charged or not charged. Yes, so actually this phenomena of the charge transfer is actually under the new title, identification of charges under the new title, transfer of charges. Yes, students. Yes, you know, you had learned one of the phenomena. What is that? Charges due to rubbing, charges due to induction. But actual transfer of charges can be well studied by a device called as electroscope. So should we learn this? Yes. Okay, let us see. Let us start with the new process, that is electroscopes. Okay, yes. What is electroscope, students? Electroscope is basically a device. It is a jar. It is a jar which has got covered by one side, and then there is, as you can see, a jar, and then there is a metal wire. What is there? A metal wire, and then in that metal wire there are two metal clips. There are two metal clips. What are these two metal clips doing? They are placed very close to each other. And here we have a big disc, or we have a same extended, a bigger metal, or you can say just a same metal, a sensitive metal piece. Then, students, what is that? This is just, let us see, let us name the construction metal wire. Yes, one more thing, what is that? Aluminium or metal foil. You know what is foil? Aluminium foil. Yes, you have it used to roll your food items and all that. Yes, take two pieces of that, keep it in a jar, and then, students, you have to use another body. Let us take a glass rod. Okay, let us take a glass rod which is highly positively charged. How to make a glass rod positively charged? Just take the glass rod and rub it over the wool. It becomes positively charged. Now, when this glass rod is brought near this metal wire, what has happened, students? Charges actually transfer. Means what? When the positive charge glass rod, when the positively charged glass rod is brought near this metal, positive charges jump over this metal wire and they get transferred over the aluminium foils. And what do happens? Positive charges get accumulated on both the aluminium foils. Positively charged glass rod transfers its own positive charge upon the two aluminium foils. When both the aluminium foils are positively charged, what does happen? Like charges. Yes, students, we learned just now, like charges repel. So these both aluminium foils move away from each other. So what happens after some time? This diagram becomes like this because they have moved away from each other. What do you understand from this experiment? That initially, when there was no charge, both the aluminium foils were together, were close towards each other. But when a glass rod was brought, they moved away from each other. Isn't it right? Yes. Now, what we will do, instead of glass rod, they are already moving aside. Now, these are charges are static. Static means what? All the charges are resting over this aluminium foil. Now, what do you do? Instead of glass rod, you take a ebonite rod. Now, ebonite rod is little different material. When it is rubbed on wool, it acquires a new charge. That is, it acquires negatively charged. It gets negatively charged. What does happen now? It gets negatively charged. Now, what happens, students? This negatively charged ebonite rod, which is how? Negatively charged, is touched to this plate. What should happen? What is your guess? Yes, reply me in the comment. When this evaluate rod is touched to this plate here, the negatively charged jump over this already existing positively charged, and what happens is that they all the positive charges becomes less because positive and negative become zero charged. Become what? Zero charge. Now what happens? This is also chargeless. This is also chargeless. This is also zero charge. This is also zero charge. So when two objects have got zero charge, what happens is that again they are having no charges. So no charges due to gravity, due to their own forces, gravitational forces, they flap down and come back to the original state. Yes, student, they've come back to original state. Why? Because there are no charges. Why? Because initially the body was glass. Glass was positively charged, and then you have this new rod that is negatively charged. But now from this experiment, what do we understand? That if you have a glass rod and you rub it and touch it on this aluminium foil, they get separated, that is they get repelled. Yes, and when a negatively charged is got, they again come closer. Yes, that means the second charge must be opposite to the first charge. Now instead, if it was in the first situation when there were glass rod was put, then it was moving away from each other. Yes, now there is a new object, okay, and it is rubbed. It is brought closer. We do not know dash charge, positive or negative. It might be positive or negative. We have to answer it. If it is brought closer to each to this plate, and after some time, what do you see, students? That it moves away even farther. That means what? The flaps are becoming more farther from each other. That means what? The already existing positive charges were made to repel even more. That means the like charges are added up into it. That means this should be positively added. That means the new object should be positively charged. Yes, student, do you see this? Okay, do you see this? What is happening? Okay, we'll draw different diagrams upon the same phenomenon. Okay, yes. So let us see what happens actually. Okay. Yes. Okay. When both are positively charged. Yes. After some time, if they are both negative, then what would happen? If it is added negative, then it will again come back. Yes, it will become neutral. This is positively charged. Yes, but the same positively charged is added with more positive charge. Then it moves more away when it is added more positive charge. But there is one more third situation. What is that? If you touch it, if you happen to touch this plate upon the top, if you happen to touch this plate at the top, if you happen to touch with your hands, then what does happen to students? You know, our hand absorbs all the positive charges on this plate. If there are positive charges or even negative charges, then hand, what does the hand do? It absorbs all the charges and pass it on to the earth. That means what? Again the body is chargeless. Okay, again the body is chargeless. So when you touch the metal plate, what is observed? That all the charges are absorbed into the earth. charges are absorbed in earth. Now what happens? All the charges get absorbed into the earth. There is no charge on this body. There is no charge on this body. So again it becomes into the original shape. And this process of transferring the charge to the earth is called as earthing. Yes, students, what is it called as? Earthing. Okay, whenever you transfer a charge to the earth, it is called as earthing. Okay, earthing means what? To transfer the charge to into the ground. What is meant by earthing? To transfer charge to the earth means what? The ground. Okay, it is sometimes also called as grounding. It is also sometimes called as grounding. What does it do? It absorbs the charges. It absorbs the charges. Yes, students, in many buildings there is earthing. Earthing is given means what? There is a copper plate, and that copper plate is put into the earth. Why it is put? Because if in some cases there is some shock, and that shock, it's due to some leakage of wire, there is some shock, and due to that, if you touch on the wall, then also you might get shock. So what does that wire do? That wire, it is kept into the ground, and it is made to touch into your meter board, into your wall. So what happens? All that, if there is some leakage in charge, that charge will go into that wire and pass on to the earth, and again this will be chargeless. So even if you touch it now, you will not get shock. So what is to be done? There is, instead of this hand, now in some more buildings, what is there? There is a different copper plate. Now this copper plate is kept far into the, dug far into the ground. This is called as earthing. Yes, students, what is this called as? This is called as earthing. So if you have to see this, watch this, try, pause the video and draw the diagram. So what is earthing? Earthing is process of transferring the charge to the ground. So draw the symbol of earthing. Earthing. Draw this symbol. Okay, students. So today we learned electroscopes and learned the principle of, yes. So this Kalpesh Dada has made it for you. This is nothing but an electroscope. Instead of two papers we have here, instead of two aluminium foils, we have two notebook papers here. Okay. So what should happen? This is a metal plate. This is a metal plate. This is a metal plate, as you can see here. And when we have, let us take a, this is a glass rod. When we rub this with any wool, then what happens? It gets positively charged. And when you touch this, if this would be aluminium foil, then it would have got separated. It would have got in this shape, because positive charges from the scale, from the glass rod, go into the metal body and go into the aluminium foil. Both become positive, so they repel. The aluminium foil repel, becomes positively charged. But if I have, this is also positive, then what happens? This will become more positive and it will become more away from each other. But I have another marker, which is I made negative charge. Then what would happen? If I touch it, the positive charge will become, and this negative charge will become neutral. So neutral means what? It will be less charged. So again it will come closer. So this is called, this entire thing is comes under electroscope. Okay, students, you can make this electroscope. It is very simple. You have to take a jar, you have to take a metal, and instead of this paper foils, you have to take aluminium foils. You can get aluminium foils in your food wrapping paper, and just make it, and you can just separately you place it and take a glass rod and touch it, and you will see that the two aluminium foils are moving away from each other. Isn't it interesting? You can make it for experiments. Yes, students. Very good. So that's it for today. Thank you.